Hi there! This video will show you how to design on a rigid drawer box Dieline template. While adding your design to the Dieline template, it can be helpful to refer back to the rigid drawer box orientation guide to see how you should place your design elements. To show you how to add your design to a rigid drawer box Dieline template, let's use this PackMojo box as a base and add some additional elements. As you can see, this box has a different color on the base tray interior, as well as logo and text elements on several panels. Rigid drawer boxes are made using pieces of grayboard and substrate materials that are glued to the board. Make sure not to add your designs to the main board. Instead, the rigid drawer box is made using 4 sheets of substrate that you will need to add your designs to. By referencing the orientation guide, we can see that there is 1 substrate for the exterior of the sleeve, 1 for the interior of the sleeve, 1 for the exterior of the tray, and 1 for the interior of the tray. Let's begin by designing the exterior of the sleeve. The back of the tray is on the rectangle side that sticks out, making the other side where the opening of the drawer sleeve is. While designs on the back will have to be rotated 90 degrees clockwise, designs on the sleeve top, which is the panel next to the rectangle that sticks out, and designs on the bottom will have to be rotated 90 degrees anti-clockwise. Designs on the sidewall below the front panel, which will be the left side when assembled, can stay in the same orientation, whereas designs on the other side wall, which will be the right side when assembled, will need to be inverted. For the interior of the sleeve, designs won't be seen unless one removes the tray. Thus, we recommend that you don't include any important designs here. In our case, we will keep it a solid color. For the exterior front wall of the base tray, your designs should be rotated 90 degrees anti-clockwise. For rigid drawer boxes with ribbons, the position of the ribbon is indicated with a line and depends on the size and weight of your box and its intended contents. For heavier boxes or products, the ribbon will have to be closer to the bottom of the box to maintain the integrity of the box. For rigid drawer boxes with thumb notches, the thumb notch will be indicated by a small semicircle. Make sure no important artwork is over the semicircle as it will be cut out. Designs on the back, the base tray should be rotated 90 degrees clockwise. Keep in mind that the back of the base tray won't be seen unless the tray is completely removed from the sleeve. For the sidewalls, designs on the left side exterior of the tray will stay in the same orientation, and designs on the right side exterior of the tray will need to be inverted. For the bottom exterior of the tray, designs can stay in the same orientation if you will be pulling the drawer out of the box sideways. However, if you want designs to be upright while pulling the drawer towards you, you will need to rotate them 90 degrees anti-clockwise. For the interior front wall of the tray, designs should be rotated 90 degrees clockwise. For rigid drawer boxes with ribbons, the ribbon position here will be indicated by a small rectangle. For rigid drawer boxes with thumb notches, the thumb notch will again be indicated by a small semicircle and should not include any important designs. Designs on the back interior of the tray should be rotated 90 degrees anti-clockwise. Similar to the exterior designs on the right side, the right interior of the tray will stay in the same orientation and designs on the left interior of the tray will need to be inverted. For the bottom interior of the tray, designs can also stay in the same orientation if you will be pulling the drawer out of the box sideways to the right. However, if you want designs to be upright while pulling the drawer towards you, you will need to rotate them 90 degrees anti-clockwise. When you're done designing, double-check it with the Dieline orientation guide to make sure that everything is in the correct location and orientation. To learn more about adding logos, vectorizing text, or embedding images, click on the link in the description or head to our website for more design tips. Happy designing!